So our approach on how to help you guys sell 100 pre-orders is multifaceted. We thought that instead of focusing on one thing, we could explore multiple options that would all contribute to the overall process of getting more exposure. So the first idea was partnerships.
Power, yeah.
That's pretty good. So in terms of partnerships, there were kind of two categories where this approach would benefit you guys. There's first expanding on the partnerships you guys currently have. You mentioned both Corner Juice and Cobb, I think Boar's Head also. And so using those pre-existing platforms to create exposure by maybe handing out pamphlets, handing out, or just exposing your technology there to the customers they're already drawing in. And you could also explore adding on new customers in places like, I think Fifth Season was one of our main ideas, just because it's already involved in hydroponics. I think they sell like homemade hydroponic kits and stuff, obviously not to the level you guys are on, but people who are going there are already looking for a hydroponic farm, and so they might be interested in your product. And then the second kind of partnership we looked into was influencers. And you mentioned this, that you had tried this a little bit when you toured your office. And so our initial reaction to that was start local, start with local celebrities is where you could certainly look into that, but people who have an influence in the Charlottesville community, places like Dead Progress, Dave Matthews Band was an idea. And then potentially influencers of the internet online.
So we also did some research on the online exposure, and what we found is that the media is reaching out to you guys more than you guys are reaching out. So we try and suggest for you guys to go out more to the media, and that you guys do post like once a month on social media, and we think maybe you should post a little more often on like some tips and new things that you guys are doing, where you're going, if you're installing in a new place, which you guys have been doing, and then just daily updates. We also had an idea of doing a Kickstarter, like the other group did, and that it's low competition, there's exposure, although there's a 5% fee and it's online and everything like that. It could get a reach out to everyone in the United States, just not in shop. So.
Okay, so basically the application is that you're just trying to reach out to your potential client base, so predominantly like upper middle class wealthy families, since the size of the farm is a major selling point, mostly urban, and then I guess broad age range mostly because financial stability is different for most demographics. But the people within your target demographic, a lot of them are on social media, so like Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and you want to be as engaging with them on those platforms as possible. Because if you wait for them to find you, then you're passing up on great opportunities to reach out to new people who might buy your products. And another one of our ideas was a pop-up store, potentially in Richmond or DC as well. So the social media presence, like, that's awesome, but you also need a physical presence component of that so that you can be there physically interacting with your customers and like directly face-to-face answering all their questions. And with the pop-up store, if you were to partner with other stores like Costco or Sam's Club and just be able to sort of briefly set up a pop-up shop within one of those, then you'd be able to potentially expand your demographic. So building and maintaining relationships with other businesses is also key for you all. Here, and then, I mean, pop-up stores, that just sort of gets your name out and reaches new customers, so.
So the last and arguably the most important aspect of this would be the relationships that you guys build with your customers. So through our survey, we got most of the same results as the other groups. We didn't feel like sharing most of those numbers, but this was kind of the biggest takeaway that we took through that survey. Second or third question they would ask is like, how do I keep bugs out of this? Or how do we make sure that my pets don't get into this? And how am I gonna make money off of this? And so we understand that you guys may not have those numbers quite yet for the maybe benefits of the of like saving money versus buying your vegetables from the grocery store. But when those do come out, that was a big aspect of the customer's concerns, and that would be a good thing to put into your marketing.
So in order to maintain relations with your customers, we think you should update the website and social media, make the information easily and accessible, and respond to customer concerns to the best of your abilities, and answer strictly with pros.
And what we mean by that is, so yeah, you don't necessarily know the exact numbers for how long it would take to break even if you were to buy one of these products, and like when did the benefits outweigh the price. And so when someone is asking you about that, instead of responding with, well, we don't know because we don't have the calculations, respond by just listing off all the benefits. So like, how long till I break even? Well, you're gonna save money on gas, you're gonna save time because you're not gonna have to go to the grocery store, you know, it's convenient, it's more fresh, you're not gonna have to buy vegetables anymore.
And lastly, just adding on to that, I don't even know if this needs to be said, but you guys, what makes your business attractive is it's a small business, it's new to the market, it's something people haven't seen before. But the relationships you're gonna make when you sell these to people are just as important as everything else, because you're gonna have to keep sending them the trays and keep in contact with them. If something breaks, they're gonna have to come to you. They can't go to any other company because no one else makes this stuff. And so just making sure that there's a good relationship between your company and your customers is arguably the most important thing that we found. Questions?